Ladies and gentlemen, Kalimera, Ula Kala. Yes, I will briefly just have a little speech about how e-navigation will transform passage planning, or how the digitalization will transform the passage planning process from being a manual process into a digital process. Just for those of you who don't know who we are a small, not so small anymore, but we are a Norwegian company headquartered in Norway, in this beautiful city called Egersund. And we are located in the building over at the right side, you can see, and we share this building together with the police station, or the legal department, as we call it. And one of the most important things we do in order to achieve our goal, which is e-navigation made easy, is to be a partner in a lot of research and development projects. Yes, we are located all around the world. These are the main projects we are currently involved in. And on this list, we have the Enable S3 project. This is an EU initiative to explore highly automated systems. And NAVTOR is the representative to the maritime world in this project. Other projects I would like to mention is the Sesame 2, where we are exploring ways of automating ship reporting. And we also have the MAR project, where we are exploring and developing solutions for augmented reality as a tool for navigation. This is maybe a little bit into the future, but it's quite exciting. But as you can see from this slide, we are involved in a lot of projects, and this has been an important part for us since we started the company in 2011. Yes, but today, just a brief how we can... first of all, I can say that the procedure to develop a complete passage plan or a description of a vessel's voyage from berth to berth consists of four stages. You have the appraisal stage, the planning stage, the execution stage, and the monitoring stage. The first step is to gather all the relevant information relevant for the upcoming voyage. And this is, as you see, the appraisal stage. A lot of information and resources are available. And all of this information is available in or located in different books and different publications or applications. So it's very difficult for the navigator, or very often the second officer, to gather all this information. The navigator also has to consider what information is relevant and where to find it, and if some documentation is complementing each other, and it takes a lot of time. The data is not integrated, it's not harmonized, and you also have to make sure that all this data is up to date, always up to date. And you need, which also is a lack of today, you need to know how to use these resources, and you need to understand how to interpret and apply this information in the correct way. So it's time consuming and difficult for the navigator to get the complete overview. So we have studied in different projects and from different angles how e-navigation technology can do this in a more safe and efficient way. First of all the data should be digital and available on board. It should be updated regularly. It should also be updated seamlessly and automatically, just as in your smartphone. And it should only be the specific or the data you will need for that specific voyage. So even on this stage, you can see that e-navigation will contribute a lot for making it being a cumbersome and time-consuming task, and to be processed in a much more efficient and procedure manner, as it will be taken care of more or less automatically. The next stage of the passage planning process is known as the planning stage. And once all this information is gathered, you have to start the process of actually laying out or planning the voyage. Here you see all the different information you have to consider when you're making the passage plan. And again, as you can see from this slide, it's a lot of information. And thus, it takes a very long time. And today, typically in a second officer, he will use a spreadsheet, an Excel sheet. And for a start, you can imagine if you should manually type in, let's say, the latitude and longitude for 140 waypoints, it takes a lot of time. And the risk for doing mistakes, typos. In addition, you also have to put in things like XTD, the cross-track distance, and all other relevant information for every single waypoint and leg. So again, we have looked at how we can make this stage more efficient with e-navigation technology. So first of all the data should be geo-referenced into the chart. It should be updated automatically at all time. And it should be automatically calculating under key clearance and taking CADSOC into account. It should automatically include and list all the information like ENC, tidal information, nav area warnings, TNP, list of radio signals, etc., etc. And maybe it should also include a safety check of the route. And we also believe that with integration into bridge networks, the route should be sent directly from the planning station to the actors. And the route and maybe also the approved passage plan should be sent automatically to the shore and to other relevant bodies or organizations. Yes, this graph is from a white paper, also from the Enable project, and was performed by a previous captain in the German Navy. And from a voyage from Barcelona to Las Palmas on the Gran Canaria island. Don't pay too much attention to the text, but it shows all the different time spent on the different tasks. And the red color is doing it manually, and the blue color is when doing it using e-navigation planning station. And the conclusion is that the time savings is enormous. From this short route, he saved 3 hours during the passage planning process. And there's also other benefits with e-navigation, and it can help the companies reduce or eliminate the deficiency related to passage planning, charts, and nautical publication. And this slide is from Tokyo MOU. They had, I think, 41,000 deficiency recorded in 2017. And you see the top 10 list here, and things related to navigation is number 3, 4, and 5. So we believe that with e-navigation, as you will have all the relevant information on board, and more or less the passage planning is done automatically, you can get rid of all these deficiencies and comply with the port state control and the vetting inspectors. Yes, I'm coming to the end. Just briefly, the fourth stage of the passage planning process is known as the execution and the monitoring stage. And just one example, you know, today when a vessel is embarking on a voyage, a factor that is still a huge administrative burden is ship reporting. There are tens, sometimes hundreds of different reports a ship may have to be obliged to submit during one single journey, many of which contains exactly the same information. And it's annoying and should be unnecessary to type in and send the same information over and over again to all these different bodies and organizations. So we are also now studying how or what implications these stages can have and how emerging e-navigation technology can improve performance of ship reporting. One of the projects I mentioned earlier was the Sesame 2, and in that project we are exploring the concept of a single window portal, which means that the navigators can use a single portal to submit all their documents for port and authority clearance. Not only that, but the project is also looking to develop a system that will enable machine-to-machine interaction without the need for manual or human input. So in other words, automated ship reporting will save the bridge officers valuable time. Last but not least, e-navigation will also improve or enhance the monitoring stage. This is a picture from the resource project, again, Enable 3, where we navigated a ship remotely with a shore-based bridge. And we see that more and more shipping companies are starting to install fleet operation centers. Someone has captains sitting 24/7, monitoring the ship performance, weather, etc., and then sending instructions or guidance to the ship. Or other companies have this just as emergency tool. So if there's an emergency, they go to the fleet operation center and they will have full overview of the vessel. So I hope the conclusion, you will agree that the digital passage planning has already started to transform the passage planning process, and it will result in enormous time savings when preparing the safe voyage, which means increased safety and consequently cost savings. And as the world continues to become more digitized, e-navigating technology will continue to unlock opportunity that up to now has been thought of as science fiction, as we are only in the beginning of the process of digitalization. Yes, thank you.